Hi Shivam, welcome to the session. How are you? Hi Anirban. Anirban, I believe it would be better if you join from tomorrow because the first class will be starting from tomorrow onwards, Tuesday 8:30. Because today it will not be. Yeah, because I haven't shared my screen. So I hope you can hear me. Class will be from tomorrow, Anirban. Class, we do have a class, but that's for existing students. And this batch is going on. So today, the topic that I'm going to cover, you'll not be able to understand. No, it's not a demo class. It's actual class, Anirban. So it would be better if you can join in from tomorrow, same time. Yes, Anirban. You can use the same link. Okay. Okay, Anirban, thank you so much for joining in. Let's catch up tomorrow. Same timing with the same link, okay? And Shivam, you also have to join tomorrow. Okay, thank you, Anirban. Hi, Ritesh, welcome to the session. How have you been? Okay. Ritesh, I hope you can hear me loud and clear. Ritesh, can you hear me? Hi, Abhiram. Welcome to the session. Okay, great. So, guys, any doubt from the last class? Abhiram, Ritesh, Shivam, guys, do you have any doubt or query from the last class? Search console, okay, not problem. I'm gonna do it today. No, search console. Guys, please keep yourself mute. Hi, Abhiram, how have you been? Shivam, do you have any particular doubt or search console is actually not clear? Great, Abhiram. Abhiram, do you have any doubt? Okay, not a problem. We'll cover again. And Abhiram, do you have any doubt? In Google Business, okay. Google Business, have you registered your business? Okay, what problem you're facing there? It has asked advanced options, as in? Thank you. Okay. So don't go for advanced options. Just register your business in a simple manner and you will receive a code from Google actually. Have you received the code from Google? Okay. Okay, guys, I'm just starting sharing my screen. Guys, can you see my screen now? Okay, great. Great, guys. So, guys, I'm just covering the Google Webmaster. Let me just log in from other account. Any doubt in regards to Google Analytics, guys? Was it clear, Google Analytics? You know how to fetch the tracking ID and add on your website, guys? Was it clear? Okay, Ritesh says yes. How about others? Abhiram, Shivam? How to calculate ROI? Okay, return on investment. Yes, that's your question. Okay, I'm gonna take that later. Let's just cover this first, Webmaster, then I'll address your question. Yes, definitely, Shivam. It's important to have Gmail account for analytics. Okay. Same for WordPress, why you need Gmail account? For WordPress, you don't need Gmail account. For Google Analytics and AdWords, you need Gmail account, Shivam. Okay. Hi, Radhika. Welcome to the session. Okay, guys. So here I have opened Search Console, which is Webmaster. Okay, and right now I've logged in from one of my clients' account, which is Adapt India. Okay, so guys, here you get to see the crawl errors, right? Can you see the DNS, which is domain network server, domain name server, and server connectivity issue or robot.txt fetch file? Okay, so I'm gonna talk about robot.txt also, guys, today. So guys, here our system is showing you server errors or access denied. There are four errors in regards to access denied, but there are no server errors as such. So guys, what Search Console is actually gonna do is, it will keep an eye on your website, okay, as it's a master, okay, and it is going to look after your website. And if there is any error on your website, then this Search Console will send you an email over your Gmail account, okay, and with the list of errors that they are fetching from your website. Okay, so it really helps to fix our website errors easily, because it becomes very difficult for our technical people also to look for those errors. Okay, so this Search Console will basically help to fetch all those server errors. Okay, so here I can see if there is any error. So right now there are no errors that I can see. Okay, some people might have tried, but the access is denied. Probably the website might be down or something during that time. So it is showing these pages which were accessed and the access was denied. So we can look on these errors and no, Abhiram, it will not show of early years. It will start from today when you start. Register. Once the tracking code is entered, only then it will start tracking your website. Okay, you will not get data of your previous years. Clear, guys? So guys, this file we can download also. We can download in CSV file or Google Docs, okay? And we can share with our client and show them these are the errors that you're facing and you can just fix it. If this is your client, you can share it with your client that or the developer of that client, or if you are working for this website and if you hire a developer, you just share this file with your developer and he will fix all these errors. So you can see this file will be generated here, okay, and you just simply share it with your customer through email. You can send the email, right? Make sense, guys? So the first and the foremost thing that Search Console will help in looking for the errors on your website, okay? So it will completely master your website. Keep looking at your website. Keep an eye on your website. So yeah, so these errors will be shared. You will not understand. Probably the technical guy, he will understand these errors about. Okay. So when they click on these pages, the technical person will get to understand what this error is all about. Yes, if you do it on WordPress, then basically, yeah, in that case also the server errors might come. In that case, you can just share with the hosting person, or you might look into that issues if there is any. But in that case, it's related to servers basically, you know, the hosting where your website is hosted. A page might not be working, probably it's down or something. Server is not responding, something like that. Okay, make sense, guys? Great, let's go back. So here is the search analytics, guys. When I click here, I'll get to see how many people have actually searched my website. Okay. Can you see all these search queries? These were the search queries which people have actually used to look for my website. This is giving me complete search analytics, guys, of my website. Can you see? These are all search queries which Search Console is giving me about what people is looking for. So you can see these are the queries which people have searched on Google. Okay, make sense? And how many clicks you have got from each query. Okay. Is it making sense? Hi Satish, welcome to the session. Great. So Shivam, is it getting clear now? Okay, great. So guys, you can also filter by date. So you can see from last 28 days here, what it is showing you, the number of clicks you have got in a particular date. Okay, this shows you the number of clicks that you have got in a particular date. Guys, you can reach this date range also, but 90 days is the last, like you can just look for last 90 days only. Okay, not beyond that. Hi Gaurav, welcome to the session. Okay, whereas in Google Analytics, you can see for, there is no limit as such in Google Analytics, right? So here in Search Console or Webmaster, you can only see data for last 90 days or 90 days only. You can change the date range, guys. Okay. So you can see this January, Feb, you can't select. So you can just start from 12th March. Make sense, guys? So guys, you can just check for on data for 90 days, the number of clicks that you have got on a particular day, okay? Then guys, search type. Okay, there is no. So let's say the search that you have got from web, so it is not, there is no data as such now here, devices. So you can see the number of clicks you have got from desktop, number of clicks you have got from mobile and tablet. Okay, again, you can see the countries data. This is your country data, guys. The clicks that you're getting from different country. Okay, this data you also get from Google Analytics, guys, and you can further drill down to city also, right? So this is only showing me for India. Okay. Then the pages, the pages on which we are getting the clicks. No, Abhiram, we don't create different website for mobile. We create one website, which is a responsive website, okay? Responsive website means that will work on mobile, that will work on tablet, that will work on desktop. But the size will auto-adjust. Sides of the website will auto-adjust. Make sense? So nowadays, every website is created responsive only. Mostly people create responsive websites only. Okay? Okay. So these are the pages on which they are getting the clicks. They can check on which pages they are getting maximum clicks, basically. That will help them to look for the data. Yes, yes, those are responsive websites. The templates are basically responsive, Ritesh. Okay. And you can filter the queries also. So I can say the queries which contain SharePoint, I just want to see for those. I can filter, and here I can see the details for those pages. And based on queries also, I can filter. Make sense, guys? This is only giving me clicks. I can also check for impressions. Here I can check for impressions. I can check for CTR, which is click-through rate. I can check for the position, guys. I hope these terminologies are clear. Any doubt with these terminologies, guys? Clicks, the number of clicks they are getting, impressions, the number of views or impressions they are getting. CTR is impressions divide by number of clicks, and position, as I told you, if the position is like from 1 to 9, that means it is ranking on first page only, okay? So guys, you can check either this query is coming on first to fifth page. So let me just search and show you. If I search for this query, what was the query? SharePoint 2016. Okay, so here I can see Adapt is the name of the website. I can't see that here. Why is not coming? Yeah, here you can see, guys, the position. It's getting second position. So it's on first page, basically, first page. For CTR, Abhiram, we have formula, impressions divided by number of clicks. So if I'm getting 100 impressions and 10 clicks, okay, so 100 divided by 10 is 10% is the CTR, okay? Guys, is it clear? So guys, if you see here, now this is coming on 13th, or like the position is 13. So let's just check whether it shows on first page or let me just go back. Here it is. What's happening? Okay, so it's still coming on first page. But the keyword is different on that keyword. Let's see if it comes on second page also or not. No, Abhiram, it's other way around. It's other way around. Click, impressions divided by clicks. Okay, let me just see the date range. No, it's like 100 divided by 10 clicks, which is 10%. Sorry, I think I've sent this to personal. 100 divided by 10, which is 10%. In which statistics you are talking about? Google Analytics? So here you can see the impressions divided by clicks. It's like 100, or you can say 131. It's in percentage, right? So you have to write 285 divided by 131 into 100. check now. Okay guys, this was about search analytics. Is it clear how you can check the analytics of your search engine? Guys, is it clear about search analytics and crawl errors? Not hearing anything from any one of you. Please reply, guys. Are you with me? Yes, Abhiram says yes. How about others? I hope you guys are not feeling sleepy. Are you guys feeling? No one is replying. Why is that so? Session is getting low. Okay, no. Okay. Not sleepy. Okay. But you guys replying late. Okay. Gaurav, we have just covered the search analytics. This part we have covered in our last class also. Overview as in. Okay. Got an overview as in. See, I will. Okay. You didn't miss much. What I told them is the search console actually helps in because Shivam was having a problem in search console. It was not clear to him. So I'm just covering that part again. So search console basically helps in tracking any errors which are coming on your website because it's the name which is given here is Webmaster. Okay. So it's going to keep an eye on your website. If there is any server error is coming on your website or if someone tried accessing your website but they face a problem like access denied on any particular page or like, in that case, this crawl errors give that messages to us, okay? So here right now, I don't see any server errors or something. So I can just download this file and share with my developer. Okay, and they can look into the errors and fix those errors. Okay, robot.txt file that I'm gonna cover today. Going back here. Yes, exactly. It's like error report of your website. Like Google has a crawler or you can say the robot who comes on your website and crawl the website on time to time, right? So if they face any problem, any errors on your website, they let us know. They will email us, okay? They will email us. And if we don't find the email also, then we are the people or company will definitely go on to Webmaster and look for the website. Okay, and like in the Webmaster, and they can fetch the errors from here. Then we have search analytics where it gives the information on the different data, like the queries on which people are searching on Google and the number of clicks that we are getting from each keyword or search query. Okay, these are the search queries through which we are getting the clicks. Okay, here you can see this information. And further, if you want to see the impressions, just check impressions. If you want to further see the CTR, just check in CTR and then position. Okay. And these are the other filters which you can use, definitely date. Filter is basically here you can see on a particular date how many clicks you have got, impressions you have got, and what position you were there, your company was there, okay? And if you want to change the date range here in this webmaster, you can just set till for past 90 days only you can check and not beyond that. For last 90 days data you can fetch, not beyond that. Whereas in Google Analytics, you can fetch more. You can fetch data for any number of days or years or months. Okay. Guys, this is what I have covered already, country, devices, search type, pages. I believe now it's clear. Gaurav, Ritesh, Abhiram, Shivam, okay? Radhika, great guys. Coming back here. Search traffic, search analytics, I already told you, link to your sites. Guys, these are the links, the backlinks that you are getting. This might not get clear to Radhika and Shivam, but I hope to other students, this might get clear what are the links that they are getting, the backlinks, guys. They are getting these backlinks. Right? Total number of links they are getting this, and these are the website on which they are getting links. Okay. These are the most linked content, like the linked web pages of this client. Yes, I have told you other website also, which is Moz Pro. Moz basically tells you the backlinks. The previous name was Open Site Explorer, guys. Open Site Explorer. Open Site Explorer. Or you can say Moz. Okay. This site also shows you the backlinks. This shows you more detailed backlinks. Here you don't get all the backlinks information. Okay. In Open Site Explorer, you will get more detail, like every backlink detail will be found in Open Site Explorer, guys. Then internal links, like if you are giving links to any other outside company or probably the internal links of your website, like, yeah, Shivam, don't confuse right now. We will cover that later in your sessions, okay? It will not get clear right now because it takes good amount of time to explain about backlinks, okay? So guys, here, these are the internal links on the website that you get to see here. As I told you already, because these links are very important, they play a very important role for Webmaster or Google to crawl a website because it becomes easier for them to index the website, right? So if they get more links on the website, they will just click on that and they will fetch the information. So as much it is important to get links to your website, the backlinks, so internal links are also equally important, guys. Okay. But that doesn't mean you just add it for the sake of adding it. No, it has to make sense. Okay. Right now there are no manual actions, so let's not just exactly, it has to be relevant, as I told you already. This is more of the here system is suggesting us the pages which are with issues which we need to fix. So here Google crawler is suggesting, yeah, from page to page. It can be internal links, yes, and external links also, but that is different. Okay, so here it's suggesting the pages which are with issues. Here we can download this file also, which we can share with the developer or fix all these issues with the pages. Okay, so guys, today this is something about Search Console here. Okay, Search Console is basically helps you first and foremost thing to look for any errors on your website. It keeps suggesting you for any errors. And also for the queries that you're getting, like the search analytics, complete analytics you get to see. Also the backlinks you can see, the internal links you can see, and the robot file that I'm just going to showcase how you can use the robot file, guys. Guys, you remember robot.txt file that we have talked about, the no follow or no index. Yes, okay, great. So let's just move forward with that. Let me just open this WordPress website. Okay, Radhika, let's just do one thing. Let's just go on to your website, WordPress. Yeah, okay, Gaurav, as I told you, this robot, like no index, do you remember that we don't want robot to come on a website or put on a particular web page and index the information? There might be reason for that, like we probably that web page is not, doesn't have the complete information, it's under construction right now, and we don't want that web page to be SEO'd by Google. Okay, we don't want to send that page, or if people find any information, we don't want to show that particular web page of our website, or probably the complete website only. Okay, it might not be in, might be under construction, the information is not valid right now, we don't want a particular web page to be SEO'd. Okay, in that case we tell Google this robot to not index a particular web page or website. Okay, so Radhika, let's just use your website. Is that correct? Can you enter your login details? I'll just give you the access, Radhika. Oh, okay, same problem. Okay, because right now I don't have any where I haven't installed. I have already installed this robot file. Gaurav, can we use yours? Okay, great. Okay, I'll tell you later, Radhika. Okay, Gaurav, here I give you the control for WordPress. Okay, guys, there you go. So guys, I hope it is not installed robot. Have you installed robot plugin? No. So let's go to plugins, guys, and click on add new. Guys, it is a bit technical, so please don't confuse yourself, okay? It's just bit technical, not much. So here we are going to find robot.txt. So guys, here you can see virtual robots.txt file, this plugin, okay? So we are going to use this one, or you can use WordPress robot.txt file also. But as these both are tested by us, okay? So you can use either of these. So let's just install this virtual robots. Click on install, and once it is installed, now you can click on activate, guys. Click on activate. Now your file will be activated, guys, okay? There are certain scenarios. Let me just open the document to explain you guys in detail. So now plugin is installed, guys. So first I'll just brief you about the text that you can write, okay? Let me just open the document from my ID. Ritesh, I know your question is pending. Don't worry, I'll answer that. Let's just cover this first. I'll let you know how you can calculate ROI, okay? So guys, robot.txt, this file basically helps us first to know index. No follow, guys, it is now discontinued, guys. No follow is being discontinued by Google, okay? Now you can just put a tag for no index. No index means, guys, when you intimate Google crawler, or you can say spider, or you can say bot, or you can say robot. These are the different names for the Google crawler or spider, okay? To not index particular web page or website. Clear? No follow tag, guys, it is now discontinued by Google, but it meant when you are giving link to some other website, okay, on your website. Let's say you have a website A, okay, and you give link to website B, guys, okay. In your website, you have mentioned about website B.com, okay. Now you just put no follow tag. So what Google is going to do is will not consider this particular link, okay. But now this does not exist, this option of putting no follow tag, because what people started doing is they tell people, okay, I'll give you a link, but they just put no follow tag. Okay, that means Google is not following that tag. Actually, it is not counted. Okay, so that's the reason, as people were, you know, faking other people's around, just telling them I'm giving you a link on my website, but they just used to put no follow tag. It just showcased they have the link, but at the back end they put no follow, so Google was not following. Okay, so now this option doesn't exist. Don't worry, Shivam, you'll understand later on, once when we do the SEO in detail. I hope others are getting this. Okay, don't worry, Radhika and Shivam. Because they don't want, people don't want their website, you know, to do much well or something. Yeah, it is definitely a good thing to give a link to other websites. It really counts your website also. As much it is important to get inbound link, it is equally important to give outbound links also. But people used to misfollow this, like misuse this concept. And they just tell people, okay, I'll give you a link, but they just put no follow link, but that link was not counted for them, okay? So that means people were just faking around. So that's the reason this has been discontinued by Google. No follow tag doesn't exist, okay? Okay, guys. So now even, you know, when clients come to us or something, they just tell us, please give us a link. But don't put no follow tag. Don't put no follow against it. So people who have knowledge about it, they just straight away say, just give us a link and please don't put no follow tag. Okay. But now if either you put no follow or you put follow, doesn't matter. Google will not consider that. Okay. So these two points are clear, guys. So now in your WordPress website, guys, you will install a plugin, which I have just told you. Install the plugin by the name of, you can just search for robot.txt and you will get virtual robot.txt or WordPress robot.txt file. So once you install this, there you get user agent. User agent, guys. Here, what you can do is either you allow, you know, there are many other robots. One robot, one you get from Google, which is bot, Google bot. This is called Google bot, the which is for Google search engine. Okay. And then you have Google bot images, which, index the images basically. Scan the images or index the images. Then there are many others also, like for this is by Yahoo. Then you have MSN, you have, okay. So these all are basically, you can either say that only you don't want Googlebot to be excluded and rest you want all the agents, like all the bots should be excluded. I don't want others to index my web page. Or you want all to index your web page, then it's okay. Then you just use the star. Guys, don't worry, I'll just show you practically, then if things will get more clear. If this query is used, that means you allow each of the bots or robots to index your website or not index your website. Or you can tell particular bot also to whether index or not to be indexed. Okay, is it getting clear, guys? Something getting clear at least? Yeah, that is from Microsoft. It's not a search engine, basically, not a complete search engine like the document search engines on your servers. Okay, is it getting clear, guys? So you can decide like what big companies do. It really depends. Okay, not a problem, Ritesh. I'm going to show it now. So guys, you have one tag which is disallow and one tag which is allow. So in allow, disallow, you can tag pages which you don't want a particular bot to index your page, or you don't want any of the bot to index your page. Okay, and then you have the allow command. Don't worry, we also have a generator also, which is called robot text generator, which generates query for us, guys. Don't worry, I'll just showcase you guys now. We have already installed on the WordPress. The plugin is installed, guys. Now you just go to settings. Guys, can you see settings? On the left hand side menu bar, guys, you can see settings option. Yes, okay. So there you get to see virtual robots, guys, virtualrobots.txt. Yes, click on that. So guys, can you see this? This is suggested by this only. This is the code. Guys, can you just give me 1 minute? I'm receiving a call from unknown caller ID. Just give me a moment. Okay, sorry guys. So guys, this is what suggested or the code which is generated by the robot only. Okay, so here you can see the disallow. If you want to disallow, you just put further URL. Okay. And the as you see here, user agent star, that means all the bots you are allowing this information, sharing this information. Okay, why we disallow login page or register page? Because we just don't want the SEO to showcase that particular page. Like, you know, you remember the payment gateway pages. Yeah, so that we don't want to be SEO'd basically. Okay. So now, based on the website here, Gaurav, based on your website, this is the code which is generated by robot file, okay? And now you can change this also. You just go and Google robot TXT generator, guys. This allow means we allow these images to be indexed by Google. Okay, and these are certain pages, JS files. You get to see files on your server, which is coming here, which is allowed. Okay. Track back must be there something on his website or on the server. I'm not sure of this. Not sure because it's coming on his website. So guys, here you can see which is a generator by SEO book, guys. Open this generator. And now can you see which action you want to take? Here you can see the code, it just gets developed. I say disallow. I want Google bot, or I don't want, let's say these are the areas which I was talking about. Googlebot is basically for Google search engine, Googlebot mobile, like anyone searching on mobile. In that case, whether we want to index like the mobile website want to be indexed or not, then images wants to be indexed or not. For Google, basically only for Google, then media partners, Google. So Google has got other tool like Google AdWords or Google AdSense. Similarly, Google has got partners, which media partners, which has all the media related agencies like advertising agencies registered, and Google share their information. Okay, if you want Google to index, like media partners to index your website or not, AdSpot is basically the landing page. So landing page of your AdWords, this is indexed by AdSpot. AdSpot index the landing pages of your AdWords. Is it getting clear, guys? Gaurav, Abhiram, Radhika, Ritesh. Radhika might not be, like Shivam and Radhika might be facing some problem to understand, but how about others, guys? Gaurav and Shivam. Gaurav, Ritesh, Abhiram. Okay, great, Ritesh. Now it's getting more clear. Gaurav, how about you? Exactly. You have to just generate and paste it there, right? Yes, that's true. And it becomes very easy. So now here I can just type in the URL of the website, which I can just start from this slash. Okay, and put here DM. And I'll say, so can you see now this code is generated? I can enter now different web page or website. Not a problem, Abhiram. Clear, guys? So you can just simply copy and paste this within your settings of WordPress virtual robot. The no index tag. Any doubt, guys? You have to paste this content, this. And let's say I have just used user agent, which is star, that means all. I can change, let's say, only Google bot. I just allow Google bot to index my this website. /. Guys, can you see? Google bot allow. Make sense? Okay, great. So guys, you can analyze also whether this code which is generated right or not. You can just go to robot.txt. So guys, robot text file has a URL which is your website name, Pulse DMA robot.txt. This is your URL, okay? I think I have, this must be getting clash because I have used the Paathshala website name. So might not show the information relevant. So here you can see multiple robot rules found. This is disallowed all robots and Google robots allowed Google. It is not important to use this file. It is only relevant if you want Google not to index any web particular page. So let's say if your particular web page is not ready, it's under construction, Radhika, then you have to use it. Or people use when a particular web page, you don't want to be SEO'd. You don't want particular web page to be indexed by Google and show it on Google search engine result page. Okay, that case you do no index. Otherwise, you just keep it like that. It's not important. Okay. Clear, guys? So guys, okay, sorry, as I have logged out. So guys, if any errors which comes here in robot.txt file, but if Google is able to fetch this file correctly, then it will not show any error. And if there is a problem, then it shows error here in the robots.txt fetch. Okay. Nothing, Aviram, nothing has happened, don't worry. Clear, guys? Okay, so Ritesh, you were having a query in regards to ROI, how to calculate return on investment, right? To calculate return on investment, you have to track the conversions, okay? So conversions, I told you already, the conversion tracking you can add on Google AdWords. Hope you guys remember conversion tracking. Yes, so yeah, so once you capture the conversions, then you start analyzing or getting reports on the ROI. Okay, so you have to make sure that the amount that you're spending has to be less than the conversion that you're getting. So let's say if you're spending 10 rupees a click, okay, and the conversion in that conversion you're getting 15 rupees. Okay, so that means you're making five rupees as a profit, which is return on investment. Make sense? So ROI will be calculated based on the conversions, not the clicks. Clear? Okay, so guys, this was about the analytics, and shall we move forward now with other topic? How can we assure the customers overseeing? How we can assure? I didn't understand your question, Gaurav. How we can assure the customers over what? Over ROI. What do they say? Yes, companies will definitely say, because their main motive is to have the ROI, exactly, increase the ROI, exactly. That will really depend on the time. Okay. Right. Okay, so let's say restaurant. So here we are not talking about the any restaurant business. Here we are talking about the AdWords, okay? So you have to make sure how you, we are not going to tell you how a restaurant business is going to earn ROI. That is completely different part. Here we are going to, we are talking about the campaign, okay? ROI on the campaign. So let's say if restaurant business is running an ad campaign, okay? Ad campaign where which is search ad, and they are spending, let's say, 50 rupees per click. Okay, they are spending 50 rupees per click, and now they want to track conversions. ROI will only be tracked if you track the conversions. Okay, if you're getting 50 clicks and how many conversions you're getting, let's say you're just getting 5 conversions. Conversions can be anything, guys. Either you can receive a call, that might be a conversion, or registration might be a conversion, or sale might be a conversion, guys. Abhiram, investment, conversion or purchase? That is formula you're talking about? Abhiram, I didn't understand your question. So let's say you are spending 50 rupees per click and you have got 50 clicks, for example, not 50 clicks, let's say 10 clicks. Okay, you have got 10 clicks, which is costing rupees 500 per click. Conversion per sale. Conversion is actually a sale. One sale is conversion. One sale is conversion. Abhiram. So guys, here, when you are spending rupees 50 rupees per click and you have got 10 clicks, so that means 500 rupees you have spent, and out of 10 clicks you have got 5 conversions, guys. 5 conversions. Okay, so you are getting 5 conversions. That might be for rupees probably 1000. So you have got 5 conversions and you have got rupees 1000. Okay, and now each conversion has cost you how much? 200 rupees, 200 each conversion. Guys, getting clear? $1,000 you have got for 5 conversions. You have got 5 conversions and in total you have got 1,000 rupees, exactly. 1,000 divided by 5. Yeah, we are going to come on that. So you have got click versus conversion. That is different. So let's say you have got 10 clicks And out of that, you have got 5 clicks or 5 conversions. Sorry, guys. So guys, here you can see conversions. You have got 10 clicks and you have got 5 conversions. Okay, and within 5 conversions, you have earned rupees 1,000 rupees, guys. Okay, or I can say not just total it 1,000. Well, that will really depend how much you have got. So let's say if people are making purchase, okay, if people are making purchase on your website, so for within one conversion, if you got one sale, that can be worth rupees, let's say 300. One sale equals 300. And how much we are spending, guys, on per click? 50 rupees. 50 rupees we are spending, guys, on click. Right? So how much we have got? We have spent 50 and we have got 300, guys. So the profit is 250. That is return on investment. We have spent 50 per click and we have got 300. But that is also not the case, guys, here. If we have got 10, let's say 10 clicks, we have got 10 clicks here and we have spent rupees 500. Guys, can you see this? We have spent 500 rupees, we have got 10 clicks and 5 conversions, right? And within 5 conversions, we have got 1,000 rupees, guys, for all these 5 conversions. 5 conversions was for total 1,000 rupees, okay? And we have spent 500. How much we have got? 500 clicks and 1,000 conversion. So 500 is the ROI. Make sense? This much total amount we have spent, guys, this much total amount, let's say in a month we have spent 500 and we have got in a month 1,000 conversions, 5 conversions we have got, okay? And if we have got 5 countries, 1,000, we have 500, and 1,000 we have got, so 1,000 minus 500, 500 is the ROI. Confused. Okay, no, Radhika says no, didn't understand. Guys, very simple logic. So guys, let's see how much we are spending. We are spending on clicks. We are spending on clicks. Okay, we are spending on clicks, right? So let's say we have spent 50 rupees per click. Yeah, we can calculate that in percentage. You can have into 100. So you can say, I'll just check in percentage. Investment is 1,000. Yeah. Yes, Ritesh. If sales is 1,500, if you say 1,500, yes, yes, definitely. ROI is 500. Yes, you're right, Abhiram. So guys, we don't have to see that per click, how much we are spending on per click. No, we have to see the whole amount that we are spending, guys. The complete amount, okay? Because if we are getting only 5 conversions, we have got 10 clicks, but we have got 5 conversions. We have to take out the cost for other 5 clicks also, guys. Make sense? We have to consider the cost of other 5 clicks also because we are paying for those clicks. Right? So we are going to consider this complete amount that we have spent on clicks, which is 500. And this is very high level conversion that I have taken. So mostly, let's say one conversion only people will get out of 10 clicks. High chances of only one conversion, guys. So if one conversion is worth rupees, let's say, yes, exactly. Returns divided by investment into 100. That's the formula. So you are getting this 1000, investment is 500 into 100. Make sense now, guys? Is it clear? So you don't have to, first point, you don't have to consider only the clicks, guys. Like per click, you have to consider the total amount that you're spending on clicks. Because you are spending, okay, clear, Ritesh says clear. How about others? Radhika says yes. So Gaurav, what you were talking about, that was altogether different. You were talking about the business, how a business can grow their ROI, right? Or you were considering in the campaign sense only. Yes. Okay. Yeah. That if the business wants to increase the ROI, then there are a lot many factors that comes into picture, not only through campaign, but a lot many other things. Such as firstly, they have to check the amount they are investing, okay? Investing in different areas, because they have to see the infrastructure, the complete infrastructure, the property where they are opening the restaurant, and the complete infrastructure, the staff members, okay? So first they have to make the complete chart for investment where they are spending, okay? And how they can cut the cost, yes. They have to see where they can cut the cost and how they can increase the profits. That really depend. They have to always do the camp, like run the campaign and make people aware about their presence and how they serve people, how they, you know, present their food, whether it's fresh or not. That all matters, okay? Only once you get business from one people and whether you're getting a word of mouth or not, people are talking about your restaurant or not. If they are talking, that means yes, it will definitely do well, and people around them, other people will also come and join in your restaurant. So your the profits will go up. So that is all, you know, which will happen, how it will happen. Okay. So business ROI will vary from business to businesses. Okay. So guys, I think we are left with less time to start with a new topic because we'll not be able to complete. In the next session, we are going to start with the social media marketing, guys, where we are going to cover Facebook, LinkedIn, Twitter, Pinterest, Instagram. Okay. You guys must be aware of social media, probably, guys. You are active on social media. Yes, okay, great. Great, so let's start the others. In case you guys have any other doubts or queries, then please let me know. Abhiram, Gaurav, Radhika, Ritesh, Shivam. Radhika and Shivam, yeah, tomorrow we are starting with the new batch. Which is same time, 8:30, and you can follow the same link. Okay. Okay, so I missed the question from Gaurav. Have you talked about this to Srishti, the subdomain? Okay. So what she said? So you want a subdomain for Pulse DMA only? Okay, okay. So your other business will be part of this business, right? Okay, yes, yes, yes. You have messaged me. Okay. Okay, let me just take that up internally with Srishti and then I'll let you know. Have you decided on the subdomain name? Is it available? It shouldn't take more than 2 to 3 days, Abhiram. Okay. Not a problem, Gaurav. Once you get to know, you can WhatsApp me. And yes, I will let you know how you can proceed further with that business because I had a word with my husband because he has got the same business and I can talk to you on that over the phone. Okay. Any other doubt, guys? On June 6th, I have done it. On June 6th, that means 7. Today is 10th, 10th, right? 12th, okay, 12th June. So you must have got by now. It's very late. Are you not getting that message? How to get WordPress username? Okay. Let me just see. I haven't tried either. So from here, you can generate password, new password. Radhika, okay, but you, okay, what you can do is you can go from your GoDaddy account and here in the account management, just generate new password. Click on this. Clear, Radhika? So here you can just click edit my profile, and when you click on edit my profile, go to account management here, scroll down and new password, generate password. Okay. Okay. And what is this website? Which website, Abhiram, you're talking about? This is my website. This is on my name, PreetiBatra.com. Okay, Shivam, please share your domain name with me and the, on which business is it? Please email me across on this ID. Okay, and I can suggest you then. Share the details of your theme, okay, of your business and your domain. Okay, guys, is it good to wind up now? Okay, not a problem, Shivam, anytime. Guys, are we good to wind up for today? Okay, guys, thank you so much. And let's meet up on Wednesday, same time with the same link. Thank you and have a good night, guys. Bye, take care, guys. Bye for now. Take care. Thank you so much, everyone. Bye.